we're getting it. I think it's hooked up correctly. I think it's working.
Thank you. compose yourselves with faith and love, be confident in your salvation in Christ Jesus, through whom our sins are forgiven. Alleluia. Amen.
It's not even registering that this isn't connected. Join with members of the community as we raise awareness of the AIDS pandemic and remember those who have died of the disease. If you love decorating, we invite you to join First Press Friends on December 3rd after the 10:30 service to help Ann Asbury hang the greens for the Advent Christmas season. There are tasks for all abilities and lunch will be provided. Please make a note on your yellow worship form if you plan to attend so they can order enough pizza. The Generosity Committee offers their gratitude to all who have returned a Generosity 2024 pledge card. If you haven't completed one, extras are available in the church office or near the bulletins, or you can fill one out online. See the chat for a link to the online form. We are grateful. You can stay up to date on all the news and events of the congregation by reading the announcements printed in your bulletin. We're very glad that all of you are here in person and online, and now let us continue our worship.
Let us pray. Shine your light on your word, O Lord. By your Spirit, let us see your wonder, for your justice outruns our sense of fairness. Your love overwhelms our deepest affections. Open our eyes, unstop our ears, and show us your most excellent way. For Jesus' sake, amen. Our first lesson today is from Jeremiah 30. Thus says the Lord, I am going to restore the fortunes of the tents of Jacob and have compassion on his dwellings. The city shall be rebuilt upon its mound and the citadel set on the rightful, on its rightful site. Out of them shall come thanksgiving and the sound of merrymakers. I will make them many, and they shall not be few. I will make them honored, and they shall not be disdained. Their children shall be as of old. Their congregation shall be established before me, and I will punish all who oppress them. Their prince shall be one of their own. Their ruler shall come from their midst. I will bring him near, and he shall approach me. For who would otherwise dare to approach me, says the Lord, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God.
Together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name, he forgets not his own. Beside us to guide us, our Lord, with us joining, ordaining, maintaining his kingdom divine. So from the beginning, the fight we were winning, the Lord was at our side, our glory. We all do extol thee, Lord, hear the triumphant, and pray that thou still defend the wilt be, that thy congregation escape tribulation, thy name be ever praised, O Lord, may.
Please join me in reading Psalm 100. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before God's presence with a song. Know this, the Lord alone is God. We belong to the Lord who made us. We are God's people and the sheep of God's pasture. Enter God's gates with thanksgiving. Go into the holy courts with praise. Give thanks and call upon the name of the Lord. For good is the Lord, whose mercy is everlasting, and whose faithfulness endures from age to age.
The fruit of all creation fails.
Today's third lesson is from the book of Joel, chapter 2. Do not fear, O soil. Be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. Do not fear, you animals of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness are green. The tree bears its fruit, and the fig tree and the vine give their full yield. O children of Zion, be glad and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given the early rain for your vindication. He has poured down for you abundant rain. The early and the later rain as before. The threshing floors shall be full of grain. The vats shall overflow with wine and oil. I will repay you for the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the hopper, the destroyer, the cutter, my great army, which I sent against you. I shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never again be put to shame. Ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I, the Lord, am your God, and there is no other. And my people shall never again be put to shame.
Please join me in reading Psalm 96. Sing to the Lord a new psalm. Sing to the Lord, all the whole earth. Sing to the Lord and bless the Lord's name. Proclaim the good news of salvation from day to day. Declare the glory of the Lord among the nations, and the wonders of the Lord among all peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, more to be feared than all gods. As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but it is the Lord who made the heavens. Oh, the majesty and magnificence of the presence of the Lord. Oh, the power and the splendor of the sanctuary of our God. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due the divine name. Come to the holy courts with your offerings. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble in awe. Tell it out among the nations. The Lord is sovereign. The Lord has made the world so firm that it cannot be moved, and will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy before the Lord who is coming to judge the earth. The Lord will judge the world with righteousness, and the peoples will sing. I invite you to rise as you are comfortable to sing.
I invite you to join me in the reading from Psalm 66. Be joyful in God, all you lands. Be joyful, all the earth. Sing the glory of the divine name. Sing the glory of God's praise. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. Because of your great strength, your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down before you, sings to you, sings out your name. Come now and see the works of God. How wonderful you are, O God, in your doing toward all people. You turned the sea into dry land, so that they went through the water on foot, and there we rejoiced in you. In your might you rule forever. Your eyes keep watch over the nations. Let no rebel rise up against you. Bless our God, you peoples. Make the voice in God's praise to be heard.
Thank you. Our final lesson is from Psalm 107. Please join me in the reading. Give thanks to the Lord, who is good, whose mercy endures forever. Let all those whom the Lord has redeemed proclaim that the Lord redeemed them from the hand of the foe. God gathered them out of the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south. The Lord changed rivers into deserts and water springs into thirsty ground. A fruitful land into salt flats because of the wickedness of those who dwell there. God changed deserts into pools of water and dry land into water springs. God settled the hungry there, and they founded a city to dwell in. They sowed fields and planted vineyards and brought in a fruitful harvest. God blessed them so that they increased greatly. God did not let their herds decrease. Yet when they were diminished and brought low through stress and adversity and sorrow, God pours contempt on nobles and makes them wander in trackless wastes. God lifted up the poor out of misery and multiplied their families like flocks of sheep. The upright will see this and rejoice, but all wickedness will shut its mouth. Whoever is wise will ponder these things and consider well the mercies of the Lord.
I invite you to rise and join me in the affirmation of faith. As grateful children of God, we strive to let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts, since as members of one body, we are called to peace. be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among us richly as we teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in our hearts. And whatever we do, whether in word or deed, we do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. You may be seated. In giving to God, we grow closer to God. Let us offer our life and labor to the one who draws near and freely gives the treasure of eternal life in Christ. Let us pray. O God of constancy, you are our home and dwelling place forever. Thank you for giving your people a gift beyond all value, the treasure of eternal life. Bless our gifts that we may offer you this day. With them may we share your love with others, that all may enter into your eternal joy. Amen.
This week, let us remember the following in our prayers. The other day, I read an article, and it said, we're not in a world war, but we're in a world at war. And there hasn't been so much war since World War II occurring at one time as there is now. So let us pray for the world, for peace, for those who've lost their lives, for the families and loved ones who have to go on with the grief of losing loved ones. Just that God's Spirit would be poured out and that some answer, especially for Mary Fuchs, Sue Korb, and Lisa Boyle. And we pray for their caregivers and all caregivers that they would find the support they need as they provide loving care to their loved ones. Let us pray for those that we may know, and even those who we don't know, that are facing their first holiday without their loved ones, and the change that is the effect of having an empty seat this Thanksgiving and through the Christmas season. And let us pray for safe travels for our youth group as they return from their retreat this weekend, and for all who will be traveling during this holiday season. We also ask that you pray for the staff of the Presbytery of Ohio Valley. Now join me in the Litany of Thanksgiving. Give thanks to the Lord who is good. God's love is everlasting. Come, let us praise God joyfully. For the good world, for things great and small, beautiful and awesome, for seen and unseen splendors. For human life, for talking and moving and thinking together, for common hopes and hardships shared from birth until our dying. For work to do and strength to work, for the comradeship of labor, for exchanges of good humor and encouragement, for marriage and committed partnerships, for the mystery and joy of flesh made one, for mutual forgiveness and burdens shared, for secrets kept in love, for family, for living together and eating together, for family amusements and family pleasures, for children, for their energy and curiosity, for their brave play and startling frankness, for their sudden sympathies, for the young, for their high hopes, for their irreverence toward worn-out values, for their search for freedom, for their solemn vows, for growing up and growing old, for wisdom deepened by experience, for rest in leisure, and for time made precious by its passing. For your help in times of doubt and sorrow, for healing our diseases, for preserving us in temptation and danger. For the church into which you have been called, for the good news we receive by word and sacrament, for our life together in the Lord. For your Holy Spirit, who guides our steps and brings us gifts of faith and love, who prays in us and prompts our grateful worship. Above all, O God, for your Son, Jesus Christ, who lived and died and lives again for our salvation, for our hope in him and for the joy of serving him. God of all goodness, hear now our unspoken prayers. Amen. And now, as children of God, let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Praise God for the harvest that comes from afar, from market and harbor, the sea and the shore, fruits brought and transformed.
praise calls for the harvest of my hands and skin, the urge to discover, create and fulfill, for dreams and inventions that promise to gain a future more hopeful, a world more humane. Praise God for the harvest of mercy and love, for leaders and peoples who struggle and serve with patience and kindness that all may be led to freedom and justice and all may be fair.
God has shown what is good. What does the Lord require of you? Do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with your God. So now go in justice, in kindness, and in humility, and may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.